At least 9 people have died following floods from the heavy rains pounding the country since March this year. A wave of destruction has now spread to more than 14 counties, with more than 6,000 households displaced, now dependent on humanitarian aid. The Kenya Meteorological Department says the phenomenon could begin to ease up starting this weekend. Let's begin our broadcast with our very own Sam Gituku.
The season of floods ravages is on across more than 14 counties, caused by moderate to heavy rains pouring in the country. 9 people have so far lost their lives, among them children. 6,221 households are reported to have lost their homes to the raging waters as major rivers, especially in western Kenya, continue to swell, clearing everything in their way. Over 4,700 acres of productive land are reported to have been wiped out, the food promise of the season now lost in the counties of Tana River, Kisumu, Busia, Homa Bay and Migori. The fatalities have been reported in 6 counties, 3 in Narok, 2 girls aged 4 and 13 lost in Siaya, while Isiolo, Wajir, Nairobi and Elgeyo Marakwet have each lost one person to the floods. This, the effect of above normal rains pounding the western, Lake region, parts of Rift Valley and Central Highlands.
As you can now see, right now we see around the Lake Victoria Basin having that pink color. The pink color is actually representing deep convection. And this deep convection is the one which is generating a lot of rainfall.
The latest records showing up to 75 millimeters of rainfall received in Embu, 65.4 millimeters in Thika, 53 millimeters in Meru, and similar downpours in Suba and Narok. Eldoret Weather Station recorded up to 67 millimeters of rainfall on Friday and Saturday last week, the highest for the region. A rainfall amount of 75 millimeters means, assuming there is no absorption in the soil, an area of 1 square meter receiving 75 liters of water within 24 hours. While such rainfall can seep through the soil, with continued downpour over a few days, the soil gets saturated, leading to runoff. As the rivers swell, flooding results, especially in lowlands, all built-up areas.
And this one was actually predicted during the monthly forecast, the one that we issued for May, whereby we said these areas are likely to experience between normal to above normal, more so over the areas within Western and Island, east of Rift Valley.
The Meteorological Department attributing the heavy rains to pressure cells from both north and southern parts of the continent.
It's being controlled from the south and the north. And the contours that you are seeing are the pressure isopass. This one has been actually helping us in terms of shifting the rainfall pairing, which is called intertropical convergence zones, to areas around the Lake Victoria Basin and more so over areas around the central western part of the country. However, in the couple of days towards the end of the week and then next towards the weekend, the rainfall amounts are likely to go down a bit.
Despite the destruction reported in different parts of the country, there are positive stories, especially in the agricultural sector. The heavy downpour expected to start declining in the next 1 week. Sam Gituku, Citizen TV, Dagoretti, Nairobi City County.